BlackTV247News for the latest information relating to the Black experience. I'm Erin Elkins, and here are today's headlines. Our top story, Nelson Mandela is in a state of mourning today after his great-granddaughter was killed in a car crash on the way back from the World Cup kickoff concert in Johannesburg. According to the Mandela Foundation, 13-year-old Zenani Mandela, one of the former South African president's 9 great-grandchildren, died at the scene of the one car accident. Authorities said the driver had been arrested and that police were investigating a case of culpable homicide or causing death by negligence. Nelson Mandela's ex-wife, Winnie, was also in the car. Her injuries are non-life-threatening. And now on the international front, Zimbabwe. According to an unreleased report, a monitor for the organization set up to halt the trade of conflict diamonds believes Zimbabwe is on track to meet international mining standards and should be allowed to resume selling diamonds in international markets. The organization, Kimberley Process Certification, is expected to follow the monitor's advice. Kimberley Process had previously recommended Zimbabwe's suspension over their findings of illicit trading and human rights abuses. A leading human rights group has criticized the recommendation, saying a decision to allow Zimbabwe to resume selling diamonds internationally should be postponed until abuses are stopped. Allegations of killings and rights violations by troops and the smuggling of blood diamonds have been associated with the discovery of the extensive diamond deposits in eastern Zimbabwe nearly 4 years ago. And that's a look on the international front. And now, sports and entertainment. Oprah Winfrey's charity, The Angel Network, is shutting down as her talk show draws to a close. The network stopped accepting donations this week and said on its website that it plans to dissolve as soon as its remaining funds are dispersed. The Angel Network was launched in 1998 with donations from viewers of Winfrey's talk show. Its demise stems from Winfrey's decision to end her Chicago-based show in 2011 after 25 years on the air. The website notice said Winfrey and the network's directors are extremely grateful to the nearly 150,000 donors who gave more than $80 million to the charity. Its best-known projects included rebuilding efforts for Gulf Coast communities devastated by Hurricane Katrina and building 55 rural schools in 12 countries. And now, on this day in Black history, we celebrate the birth of gifted legal scholar and federal judge Amyla Lyle Kearse. The Michigan law graduate was a partner in the Wall Street firm of Hughes, Hubbard, and Reed before President Carter made her the first female ever to be appointed to the Second Circuit Court of Appeals. Aside from her distinguished legal career, Kearse is a world-class bridge player. She's the 1986 world champion and a 7-time U.S. national champion that has loved the game and the law since this day in 1937. Well, that's it for us here at BlackTV 247 News. For more information on the stories covered during this newscast, please visit us at BlackTV247News.com and click on the story links. Until Monday, I'm Erin Elkins. Have a world-class weekend, and remember, you can catch us online 24/7.